Police body camera footage captured the moments that Central Marin Police responded to a 911 call in San Anselmo. That call placed by Elise Frankel, who woke up late one night in August 2022. She says her then fiance, now husband, Bruce Frankel, was gasping for air, and she says he was clearly having a medical crisis. Elise says she was expecting EMTs to respond when she called 911, but Central Marin Police officers arrived first, and she says instead of treating Bruce like a victim, treated him like a criminal.
He jumped on him and tackled him on the ground. It was very scary just watching the whole, seeing the whole situation.
Bruce Frankel says he doesn't remember the encounter and can't bring himself to watch the video.
No, I can't do that.
Too traumatic.
I can't keep reliving this over and over and over again. I have not watched the videos.
Doctors later determined that Bruce Frankel was suffering a grand mal seizure, unaware of his surroundings and unable to comprehend what was going on. In the video, Bruce can be seen mumbling and pushing the officer as the officer tried to grab him. He said he was treated like a criminal instead of a patient in need of medical care.
If the police arrived and had just asked Elise, you know, two questions, what's going on and has this happened before, none of this, we wouldn't be here today. But they didn't, that officer did not do that at all.
Documents reviewed by KTVU say that police officer Kevin Sinnott said that Frankel actively resisted him for more than 2 minutes. The officer ultimately pulled his taser and shocked Frankel twice. An internal review found the officer's use of force was justified. The responding officer's attorney releasing a statement reading in part, quote, "While we now know this was the consequence of a seizure, at the time the officers had no such information and acted in accordance with training, law, and policy. All the officers wanted to do was help make sure everyone was safe."
I've always respected the police until now.
The Frankels say eventually EMTs arrived on scene and Bruce Frankel was taken to the hospital where he was treated and arrested for resisting arrest and faced domestic abuse allegations. Frankels say that's when they began digging into the events of that night, eventually spending more than $10,000 to clear Bruce Frankel's name. The Marin County District Attorney ultimately did not file charges, but now the Frankels have filed their own lawsuit alleging abuse at the hands of Central Marin Police Department. Their attorney saying the responding officers rushed to judgment, using force when medical care was called for, and then started collaborating on their stories to build a cover-up.
We're trying to hold people accountable for some really bad decision-making that taints an entire department, which is not good.
The chief for Central Marin Police Department released a statement about the incident and lawsuit, reading in part, quote, "The authority will vigorously defend itself against this meritless and factually inaccurate litigation, which has not even been served upon the authority as of yet. Unfortunately, this individual has decided to first litigate his case in the media rather than in court, where we are confident the action of our officers will be vindicated."
Are you doing CPR?
Okay.
What's wrong?
He's conscious. Something's wrong with him. Can you step
yeah,
up?
He's got a hurt. Can you
you okay?
Leave me alone.
Stop. Are you okay? What's wrong?
Baby, he's
fighting with me. Please leave me alone.
He's fighting with me.
Please help me.
Stop. Stop fighting with me.
Stop fighting.
Police, stop fighting!
He couldn't breathe,
sir! Okay,
well,
he's fighting.
He's unconscious!
He's not unconscious!
He is!
He's fighting!
Come on!
Why did he break his neck!
Stop!
He's unconscious!
What
are you doing?
Yeah, let me tell him! Okay, let me just fight.
Okay, it's right back. Please put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back. What's his name?
Bruce.
Stop. Stop resisting.
Bruce. Who's not here?
Stop fighting! Get on your stomach! Get on your stomach! I want to help you. Stop fighting. You're going to get tased. Do you want to get tased? Land your stomach. Put your hands behind your back. Are you his wife? Stop. Stop fighting.
What?
Well, more people are coming. What, did he kill somebody? Yes, ma'am. Please get back.
Oh my God, how can I come to see you? Baby, don't fight, please.
So you're gonna get tased. You're gonna get tased.
Stop fighting. Oh my God! He's not just gonna.
Okay, well, he's just stop fighting with me. Lay on your stomach. Lay on your stomach, please. We want to help you. Okay, well, I can't treat him unless he stops fighting.
Oh, we're pulling back.
Breathe.
Stop fighting.
Can you help? Can you get the officers inside?
Yeah.
You're fighting with the police. Land your stomach. Land your stomach. Put your hands behind your back. Put your other hand behind your back. Now.
Don't fight. Don't fight
them. Do you want to get tased again?
I'm right.
You're going to get tased
there.
Again. You want to get tased again? Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back. Help. Trying to get him in cuffs. He's been playing with me. Get on your stomach. I got one cuff on
here.
We could drag him out a little. This arm. So I'm trying to pull it back. Should we pull him back? Yeah, we've been fighting for 5 minutes. I don't think he's tired. Let them work in. Sure, I got one cuff on him.
Just drag him out.
Okay.
Just drag him out.
Just pull him back. Ready?
Oh, shit. I got his feet.
On his stomach? This arm? Give me this arm. Put it behind your back. That cuff is already on him. He's got to get this arm.
Yep.
Put your hands on your back. Put your right, your left hand on your back. Answer for me, Kate.
Sir. Sir. Stop resisting. The fire department here to help you.
Someone say. Let go of the handcuff. Okay.
I drive stunned. You just did.
I'm so sorry about that.